Good morning, students. My name is Mandeep Kaur from California Public School. Hope all of you are fine. So let's start today's topic. We are doing the chapter vectors, and its first worksheet we already have finished. So today I'm going to start from the second worksheet, and this worksheet is based on the scalar product, or we can say the dot product. So let's start from the very first question of the exercise 1.2. So in the first question, here it is given. If A vector is a unit vector, so if A vector is a unit vector, that means its magnitude is equal to 1. So this is given in the statement that A vector is a unit vector, that means its magnitude is equal to 1. And here it is x vector minus of A vector, and its dot product with x vector plus A vector is equal to given 15. And here we have to find out the value of x vector and its magnitude. So this we have to find out. So here is the dot product. That means we have to do simply its multiplication here. So x into this after minus a into this. So firstly, x dot x is here. After here is plus, here is also plus. So that means x dot a vector, then minus a dot x, and then plus minus minus a vector dot a vector is equal to 15. Now x vector dot x, so it can be written as x vector and its magnitude square. Now listen, here is x dot a, this is the positive and this is the negative, and a dot x and x dot a in the dot product always remain same. So this positive and negative will be cancelled with each other. So here is a dot a, so it can be written as a vector and its magnitude square. So this is equal to 15. So now look, the vector A and its magnitude is given equal to 1. So we can put here the value of A vector magnitude. So 1 square will become obviously 1. So I'm going to write here, this is 1 equal to 15. So this is negative, and the right side it will be positive. So that means the x vector and its magnitude square will become equal to 16. So here is square, that means the magnitude of x is equal to plus minus 4. But we know that its magnitude is always positive. So you have to write only the positive one. So this is the value of x and its magnitude that we have to find out. So come to the next question now. So now in the second question, so for this I have to rub this one. Now in the second question, what we have to find out now, I'm going to write here. So, if here is A vector minus of B vector, and its dot product with A vector plus B vector is given 12. So, this is the second question. Its dot product is given 12, and A vector is equal to twice of B vector magnitude, that is given. And we have to find out the A vector magnitude and B vector magnitude, that we have to find out. So this is equal to given 12, and this is equal to twice of B vector magnitude, and here we have to find out the A vector magnitude and the B vector. So simply we have to do it's the dot product here. So this will become A vector dot A vector. So this is plus A vector dot B vector. So this is B vector dot A, and plus minus minus. So B vector dot B vector is equal to 12. So after it can be written as A vector and its magnitude square. So A dot B, B dot A will be cancelled with each other. So here is B vector and its magnitude square is equal to 12. Now look, here the value of A vector and its magnitude is given twice of B vector magnitude. So we can put here, so twice of B vector magnitude. Here is square, so I'm going to write here the square. So minus of B vector its magnitude square is equal to 12. So now here it becomes 2 square, that is 4. So B vector magnitude square and minus of B vector magnitude square is equal to 12. So 4 and minus 1. So that will become 4 minus 1, 3. So this is 3, and B vector magnitude square is equal to 12. So 3 will be divided on the right hand side. So B vector and magnitude square, so 3, 4 are 12. So again the two values are there, but the magnitude is always positive. So I'm going to write here only the positive. So B vector and its magnitude is equal to 2. Now we have to find out the A vector magnitude. And here it is given that A vector magnitude is equal to 2 times of B vector magnitude. So we can put down the value here. So this is 2 and its value is also 2 that we already have found out here. So 2 2s are 4. That means the A vector and its magnitude is equal to 4. Come to the next question of this worksheet now. Okay, now the next question of the worksheet is in the third question. If the angle between the two vectors, so well, we have given the angle, so I'm going to write here the formula. So firstly, look the statement. If the angle between the two vector, A vector and B vector, of equal magnitude. So firstly, it is written here the A vector and the B vector magnitudes are equal. So this is equal to this one. And the angle between these vector, that means A vector and B vector, the angle between them. So let us suppose this angle is theta. So I'm going to write here theta, that is given 60 degrees. So theta is the angle between A vector and B vector. Its magnitudes are same. So afterward, and the scalar product, that means the dot product between these two vectors is also given, that is 1 by 2. So find their magnitude. That means we have to calculate what is A magnitude and what is B magnitude. So this we have to find out. Now look. So when we have the angles, we have to use the formula. The dot product of two is equal to the A vector magnitude, B vector magnitude into cos theta. So this formula we have to use here. So dot product is given 1 by 2 and we know its magnitudes are same. So we can write here A vector and A vector, because B is also equal to A vector. Or you can write there both A, or we can write here the both B also. So I'm going to write here A vector and A vector, because B vector is equal to A vector, that is already given the magnitude. So cos and theta is given 60 degrees. So I just have put down the values here. So this is 1 by 2 and it can be written as A vector and its magnitude square. So cos 60, that is 1 by 2. So this is 1 by 2. So multiply, maybe we divide in this side. So this will become 2 by 2, that is equal to 1. So this is A vector magnitude square. So obviously the value of A vector magnitude is equal to 1. So here the magnitude of A is equal to 1. So in the beginning, it is given that A vector magnitude and B vector magnitude are same. So that means if A vector magnitude is 1, that means obviously the B vector magnitude is also equal to 1. So come to the next question now. In the fourth question, again the A vector magnitude is given 3 and the B vector magnitude is given 4 and the dot product is also given, and here we have to find out the angle. So let us suppose that theta is angle between, let theta be the angle between A vector and B vector. So again we have to use the same formula, A dot B, that is A vector magnitude, B vector magnitude into cos of theta. Simply write down the values here, A dot B, that is 3, A magnitude, that is 3, B magnitude, that is 2, and cos, so theta we have to be find out. So this is 3, 3 2s are 6, will be divided in this side. So this is cos theta. So that is 1 by 2 is equal to cos theta. So that means we can say theta, cos will be 1 by 2 at 60 degree. So that means theta is pi by 3. So this is our answer. So come to the next question of this worksheet now. Okay, now the next question of this worksheet is, here we have to find out the projection A on B. So how can we find out the projection? So here dot product is given and the B vector is also given. So I'm going to write here the projection. Here we have to find out the projection of A vector on B vector. So this is actually equal to the dot product of both these vectors divided by this one magnitude, the B vector. If it is written, we have to find out the projection of B on A. So if we have to find out projection of B on A, so here we have to use the dot product of both divided by this magnitude, that means A vector magnitude. But here we have to calculate the projection of A on B, that means the dot product divided by this magnitude, the second vector magnitude, that means the B vector magnitude. So here just you have to put down the value A dot B, that is given A. And its magnitude, we know that. How can we calculate this one? So here is 2 square 4, 6 square is 36 and 3 square is 9. So here is 4 plus 9, 13, 13 plus 36, that is 49 square root, and square root of 49 is 7. So which is our required answer? So come to the next question of this worksheet now. Okay, now the next question of this worksheet is, here the A vector is given, the B vector is given, and we have to show the vector A plus B and A minus B are perpendicular to each other. So in the condition of perpendicular, so let us suppose the two vectors are there, A vector and B vector. So when they are perpendicular condition is there, we have the perpendicular condition is there. That means we have to show their dot product should be equal to zero. So in case of the perpendicular, their dot product should be equal to zero. So here we have to show that A plus B and A minus B are perpendicular. That means what we have to show here, A plus B and its dot product with A minus B should be equal to zero. Then we can say that these are perpendicular to each other. So for this, firstly, we have to find out what is A plus B and what is A minus B. So firstly, I'm going to write here A vector plus B vector. So addition of both these vectors, so 5 plus 1, that will become 6 I cap. So here is plus 2 j cap and the last one is 5 3 8 k cap. So afterward, what is a minus b? So this minus this, 5 minus 1, that is 4 I cap. So minus, and here is will become also minus, so 5 minus of 4 j, and this minus and this will become the positive, so minus 3 plus 5, so this is plus 2 k cap. So now we have to find out their dot product, a plus b with dot its a minus b. So I'm going to write here, this is 6i plus 2 j cap minus of 8 k cap and its dot product with 4 I cap minus of 4 j and plus 2 k. So simply we have to do its dot product. So look, when we will do the multiplication, that means the dot product, this with this. So I dot I always equal to 1, j dot j, that is also 1, and k dot k, that is always 1. And with different I dot j, or we can say j dot I, that is also 0, I dot k, j dot k. So different one are always 0 and the same one are always 1. So simply you have to do its dot product now. 6i into 4i. So 6 4s are 24, I dot I will become 1. So when you will do 6 into minus 4, this is I, this is j. So I dot j, that is obviously 0. So you have to skip this one. In the similar, this is also skip. So simply you can calculate this into this, this into this, this into this. Clear? Because the remaining will become the zeros. So 6 into 4, that is 24. So plus 2 into minus 4, that is 4 2s are 8. Minus 8 into plus 2, that is 8 2s are 16. Because the rest one will come 0. And I dot I is 1, j dot j is 1, and k dot k will become 1. So now look, here is 24 and 16 and 8, that is also 24. Negative of 24, this is 0. So that means the a plus b and its dot product with a minus b is 0. That means we can say that these vectors are perpendicular to each other. Hope so these all questions are clear to everyone. So tomorrow we'll discuss the remaining portion of this worksheet. So thank you so much, everyone.